I know you can argue, but he will do it. That one I know. Bismillah, brother. We trust you. We believe the man. So, now, I want him to lead Salah. He can do it, Bismillah. He will do it. You just make it come, he will do it. This is his day, man. No, he will lead Salah. He will lead Salah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala as-salati, hayya 'ala al-falah. Qad qamat as-salatu, qad qamat as-salatu. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah.
Social distancing is very important. Social distancing is important. Sure. Give a space. Social distancing is important. A bit of space. A bit of space, Ahbab. I don't know if the, is the door open up? Kamal. Kamal, you know, a small one. Kamal, can you check if the door is open? Okay. Social distancing is important. When you go to sujood, you use that. You can use the room. Bismillah.
Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Maliki Yawm Al-Din. Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'in. Ihdina As-Sirat Al-Mustaqim. Sirat Al-Ladhina An'amta Alayhim. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر.
الله
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. الله سمع الله من حمده. الله أكبر. Allahu Ekber. 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 السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم وبركاته. I have 10 questions straight to be answered by you. One, if you know answer me straight, if you don't know, then it's 10 questions. One. 10 questions. Very general questions. Ready for it? Who began Islam? And what is your proof? Question number one. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Who began, who founded Islam? And when? What is your proof? Bismillah. Don't Google. 10 questions. Please help me. I want to let you go. You've been here since Asr. You're in America. Part of challenges is the information, right? Wrong or right information. Now, who began an Islam, when, and what is your proof?
Islam was before everyone. Like, Islam is before Adam.
He says Islam has been there, and the first human Muslim is Adam. What is your proof as a Muslim? Well said, but what is your proof? Bismillah. Now.
You just explain it to me. That's it.
Help us, help us. I take 10 questions, I want to let you go. Who began Islam? He says Islam was there even in the time of Adam. Correct. What is your proof of that? Where do we get that? If a non-Muslim or a Muslim who is struggling to learn asks you, where is the proof?
Bring them to you.
Brothers say they will bring them to me. I may be in Kenya. Now.
So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Ma khalaq al jinna wal insa illa liya'budun, he's saying that because he created the jinn and the insa and the humans to worship him, so Islam is even before
where there is an explicit ayah or hadith stating that Islam was there before Muhammad. Remember, non-Muslims, especially critics, do call us Muhammadans. Have you heard that name? In some ancient books, they call us Muhammadans. So I agree with you that Islam was there and Adam was a Muslim, right? Before Muhammad. What is the proof? Now, so I will help you quickly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran chapter 3. Chapter 3 is which surah? Chapter 3 in Quran is which surah? If you don't answer, you're going to pay me. Ali Imran, right? Just, that is why I say 3:19. Simple. 3:19 is easy to hope. 3:19. Allah say, Inna deena indallahi. That the religion with Allah is al-Islam, which means was, is, and will remain to be the true. But if you want a direct ayah, chapter 22, ayah number 78. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say that وَجَاهِدُ فِي اللَّهِ حَقَّ جِهَادِ and strive in the cause of Allah truthfully and sincerely. هُوَ اجْتَبَاكُمْ He, Allah, has chosen you. وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ He never imposed any hardship on you in this religion. Millata abikum Ibrahima. This religion is the religion of your father Ibrahim. Huwa sammakumul muslimina min qablu wa fiha. It is he who named you Muslims before and in this. Before and even in this Quran. So that those are two clear proofs, right? Second question. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad? Hey. What is the proof that he's the last Messiah? And you Muslims, do you believe in Isa ibn Maryam Jesus? Yes. So why should you believe in Muhammad if you believe in Isa? What is the proof that Muhammad is the last messenger? And if you believe in Isa, why then should you believe in Muhammad if you believe in Isa? Who's gonna answer this question? Two in one. Those are the questions of that one. You meet with Jehovah's Witness, you meet with Seventh-day Adventists, you meet with Catholic, you meet with Mormons, they will ask you this question. What is the proof in your Quran that Muhammad is the last messenger? Brothers, Bismillah.
Prophet, you said give glad tidings upon the Muhammad Prophet.
He's saying we believe in Isa, but we also believe in Muhammad as the last messenger because Prophet Isa gave glad tidings, good news about the coming of Prophet Muhammad. Jazakallah khair. What is your proof?
I don't know the ayah, but it seems to suffer.
Allahu Akbar. He say he doesn't know the ayah, but it is in Surah 2. So Surah 2 Saf is chapter 61 in Quran. Sabbaha lillahi ma fi samawati. After a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم I love reading that surah. Then Allah says وإذ قال عيسى بن مريم and remember when Isa son of Mary said not son of God son of Maryam يا بني إسرائيل he was a human being he said O Israelites O children of Israel إني رسول الله إليكم مصدقا لما بين يدي من التوراة verily I'm a messenger Allah sent to you Isa was not sent to Alameen to the whole world he was sent to Ben Israel only. He say, Musaddiq al-Lima bayna dayya min al-Tawrah. One of my mission is to, I'm going to reduce my question to five, okay? Five, not ten. I came to confirm that which came before me of Tawrat given to Musa. Wa mubashiran bi rasulin ya'ati min ba'd ismuhu Ahmad. And also I have come to give you a glad tidings. That was the ayah, right? Of a prophet who will come after me, whose name is Ahmad and Muhammad is the same person. So when he came to them with clear signs, قالوا هذا سحر مبين, they say this is a clear magic, you know. So Alhamdulillah, we believe in Isa as a Muslim who was sent to Bani Israel, but before he left, he said that Muhammad had to come. That is why all of us should believe in. Now, do you have an ayah where Allah says that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah? Any ayah? Surah Al-Ahzab. Ma kana Muhammadun aba ahadin min rijalikum walakin Rasulullah wa khataman nabiyyin. Jazakallahu khair. Muhammad is not any father of you. We don't call Muhammad our father. Lakin Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, and he is the seal of all prophets, meaning he is the last of all messengers. Three more questions. Can I ask another one? Between Isa and Rasulullah, was there any other prophet? What is your proof if it's not? The last surah shows clearly that after Isa came Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Christians are saying this. In the name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You heard them saying that. They believe in three in one, one in three, right? A professor Christian who teaches math in any institution. In class, you say 1 + 1 + 1 + 1 is? But when it comes to the church, you say 1 + 1 + 1 is 1. 10%. So we Muslims, Allah say, وَلَا تَقُولُوا ثَلَاثَةً. Do not say God is three. إِنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ. For your God is only one God. I want to ask you a question. Based on that, if they tell you that, how would you argue with them? You are studying on campus, right? And they are knocking our doors. If they tell you that, no, we believe that one is three and three is one, what would you tell them? They say Allah is God. They call him the Father. And then they say Isa is the Son of God. Mm-hmm. So he's a God son. And they call Ruh al-Qudus. Jibril is also another third God. How will you argue with that? Bismillah.
Why is there more than God? There's more than one God.
He's saying that he will ask them why. He will tell you, no, that is my belief.
I mean, I know that's his belief, but there's only one God.
He said, I believe in one, but it is like an egg. You see an egg? What is inside? Yeah. And then what follows? Yeah. And then what follows? They say it is the same egg, so they believe that that is how God is. They tell you, no chai, tea. You call it chai because of there is a milk, there is. And? They say just like that. So how will you challenge this? Now. MashaAllah. Surah Al-Ikhlas is enough to finish this. If you don't convince them, at least to convince you. Qul huwa Allahu. Period. Say Muhammad, he is Allah, one and only. The second ayah is Allahu. Allahu Samad. Allah is independent from his creation. Lam yalid. So if Allah lam yalid wa lam yulad, it means that he begat not, nor was he begotten, right? So Allah does not make, he doesn't need to have children. And then, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ Allah, there is nothing like unto Allah. So you cannot liken Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with anything. Fourth question and fifth one. Can you mention at least two women who were mentioned in Quran by name? Please think and watch your mouth before you answer.
Maryam.
The second one?
Asiya.
People like this, we need to send them to Masjid Golden. We need to send them to Asiya. Masjid Golden. Or Masjid. Two names of women who are mentioned by name in Quran. Huh? I give you one, Maryam. And the second one?
Asiya.
Which ayah? What is your proof?
This is the last...
By name. Many women are mentioned by name. Yeah. To the extent that there's a surah called Surah An-Nisa. But by name. Only one. No, there is no name Hawa. So only Maryam is mentioned by... But Allah has mentioned many, many... Last question. Listen to this now. Last question. How can a young man... No. should you attend Jannah as an old man, or you can still attend Jannah as a young man? Should you attend Jannah as a grown-up old man, or at this age you can still strive and attend Jannah? Convince me. How? Give me three ways that can make a young man attend Jannah. Microphone is there for young man. Sometimes we need to talk like this, right? Listeners digest, it's called like that. Jannah, is it for only elderly people, grown or young people? How can a young person attend Jannah? Three ways. Bismillah. Microphone is it. I want to sanitize it before you touch it. Come here. Ali. Doctor Oro. Sanitize. No corona. Three ways of attending Jannah, young people. Because normally you say, inshallah, I'm enjoying my life. Once I grow, I get married, I make babies, inshallah, I will be worshipping Allah. Some people are talking like that. Not you, some people.
So common.
You know, this is my time, you know, I'm still young, man, you know. You know those stuff, right? You know those stuff. You can't talk unless you... Yo-yo-yo. That stuff of yo-yo-yo. You talk to mom, you know, mom. You have to.
Put your hands like that.
A little bit of swag, you know? A little bit of... I love you, Allah. I love you. I'm not mocking at you, you know? Sometimes it's just extra, eh? Good. So the belt that you have doesn't really. So the problem is in Salah. The problem is in Salah because Satrul Aura, covering your aura from, you know, aura, what is considered to be a private part of any man. It's above your belly button until below your. So if here is open in Ruku, brothers, the whole walnut is up. You saw given in Salah. Please cover it in Salah. Cover it in Salah. I don't say that now you are evil and what. No, I say if I'm fixing here as Imam Shafi, I also have my weaknesses. Just improve it. Just know that like in Salah, at least start with Salah, right? Allahu Akbar. So three ways of entering Jannah, or at least attaining Jannah. Youths, please stop. This condition is not going to remain forever. You know that you're not going to remain like this forever. 1 year, 2 years from today, you will be advising other youths.
Somebody give a hand.
Bismillah. This is called do that now.
I'm being told to advance.
No, you're not talking to me. It's too much.
Be respectful to your parents.
Okay. Sweet. No, I need full package.
I will help him.
No?
Help him. I will help him.
No, you are not a youth. Sorry.
You say I will help him.
No, yeah, that's good. Sorry. You want to come back to you? No. And you cannot put food by here, put in your hand.
So like you mentioned before, be respectful to your parents, because I think documented it said Jannah is below your mother's feet. And another is asking Allah for forgiveness. That's another. And Salat as well. Yeah, Salat.
You can imagine if this is the Habib in this masjid. He's done with football. You call a long adhan, long adhan, until la ilah. Then he say, obedience to your parents. Because Rasul said, Jannah is under the feet of your. What was the second point? He say, asking Allah for forgiveness. Then he sits down. First photo. Second quote by say, he's asking people, what about Salah? Then he say, Atom is Salah. These are the laughter. Yes, yes, those are some of them. Look, you stand a better chance. Nobody's lecturing you a lot. Just be responsible. That is my advice to you. Be your own what? Just be responsible. Just do self-evaluation. If you live as a young man, if you live longer, wallahi, one day you're going to regret this age. You may regret it. I'm 46 and I've started feeling that I'm not young sharp yet, 20 is 19. Wallahi, my son is your age. My son is 23 years old. I see him having good hair like yours. My son is a young man as well, you know, so wallah. And you are all my brothers. Just be responsible. And just understand that, you know, Allah created you, He blessed you to be a youth Muslim. And so just, you know, struggle and mend your relationship with Allah, strengthen it, you know. And one of the best places of changes is the masjid. I said 5 questions, Jazakumullah khair. Jazakumullah khair for coming. Come here in the canal. Jazakumullah khairan for coming. Make this place to be your home. And you two are working, even $10, donate towards this masjid. Just commit $5, $10. On this place, inshallah, own it. On this place, Jazakumullah khair. If we wrong you in any way, forgive us. Right? If we wrong you in any way, forgive us. Let us have free talks with respect, and you know, inshallah, everything will be okay. You are the hope of Muslims in this country. You are the leaders. You are the leaders. We don't want you to be followers, we want you to be the leaders from now. Jazakumullah.
Jazakumullah khairan to everybody for coming. As you guys could see, or as you guys could see, slowly in our Shafi'i's dream of having the adults pray outside is coming true because of the youth being here. So Jazakumullah khairan for making that happen. We'll have our youth group tomorrow. Story of Prophet Adam, inshallah. This time it'll actually happen, inshallah. So tomorrow the sisters will have their own halafa between Asr to Maghrib, and the brothers will have our own halafa between Maghrib and Isha. And inshallah there will be snacks. So we'll be there, inshallah.
You told me today.
we have milk. Anybody who wants
to? We got chocolate milk.
We have chocolate milk. Please open the fridge. We have food as well.
We got cooking oils if you guys want.
You can open the fridge. We have the, how do you call it? Microwave is there. We can help you out to connect it.
Cereals.
Please feel free. We have fresh milk if it doesn't disturb your stomach. Cereals. You can also take part of it home.
Yeah, cereal.
You can take milk home, inshallah.
Jazakallah, guys. Thank you guys all for coming. That's all. Tomorrow, inshallah, don't forget. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Oh, yes, the second quarter, huh?
Go.
Thank you.